Hey guys, in this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you how I made this liquid reveal effect without using any third-party plugin. It's a completely procedural effect, so you can easily swap between different text, logos, or even pictures, and everything is going to auto-update in the main composition. So with that said, let's begin. Okay, so in After Effects, I created a composition with 1920 by 1080 pixels, 24 fps and 5 seconds long and named it D-Map. I created a white solid and named it Wave Motion. After that, I applied the linear wipe effect with wipe angle set to 180, then animated the transition completion from 100 to 0. I selected both of the keyframes and hit F9 to easy ease them. After this, I added the wave warp effect and set the wave height to 30 and the wave width to 300, and make sure to pin the all edges. So this gives us this wavy motion going up. After this, I duplicated the layer and renamed it Bubbles. Applied the CC Bubbles effect by going Effects, Simulation, CC Bubbles. As you can see, if I solo this layer, CC Bubbles create these floating bubbles with upward motion. You can use different types of particle system to create this, but for this one I stuck with CC Bubbles. I'm curious to know, have you guys ever used this effect? Comment down below how. In CC Bubbles effect, I changed the bubble amount to 5000, bubble speed to 2, and shading type to none. As you can see, this gives us this solid white floating bubbles going up. After this, I unsolo the bubbles layer, selected both of the layers, and hit U to reveal their keyframes. And in the bubble layer, shifted the transition completion keyframe to around 4.12 marks. And now if you see, this gives us this wavy bubbly motion. I duplicated the bubbles layer again and renamed it Bubble Small. Offsetted the transition completion keyframe around 4 seconds. And in the CC bubble effect, changed the bubble speed to 3 and the bubble size to 2. As you can see, it gives a variation to the upper bubbles. Now, if we take a closer look in the composition, we can see that all the forms are still separated. I wanted them to fuse together and make it look more gooey and watery. For that, I added an adjustment layer with an Gaussian blur effect set to 16 and a level effect. Set the channel to alpha and set the alpha input black to 25 and alpha input white to 36. Now if we look, we can see all these layers are fused together. After this, I duplicated the bubble small layer and renamed it to bubbles tiny. Put it over the blur and levels layer and offsetted its transition completion keyframe to around 3.12 and change its bubble speed to 4, bubble size to 1 and the bubbles amount to 4500. This just added more variation and make it look more fizzing like a soda. And this is how the entire map looked. At this point, we're almost done. I created a new composition with the same values and renamed it Placeholder. This is the composition where you want to put all your texts or logos to be affected by this effect. You just change the assets of this comp and everything else is going to be auto-updated. For this example, I just put a simple text in this comp. I created a final build composition and put the placeholder and D-map comp in them and used the D-map as a track mat for the placeholder. And that's it, that's the core effect is done. Now if I zoom in, you can see the edges around the placeholder are quite crisp. In order to make it blend more with the map, I added an adjustment layer and added the roughen edges with border value set to 5. And that just made it look more fused together and organic. I put the final build in a final composition and trimmed it so it started a bit early. And after that, I duplicated the comp couple more time and added different colored fill to them and offsetted them to get a cascading effect. And that's it. This is how you achieve this effect. As you can see, it's a pretty simple and quite versatile one, and it's completely procedural. So just change the source and all the effects is going to be auto-updated in the main composition. It's quite customizable too. As you can see, just by changing the angle of the linear wipe, we changed how the reveal direction looks. Or in this one, where I changed the placeholder comp's colors from simple solid to different types of textures. So really, the ideas are limitless. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure to download the free project file in the description and experiment with the values to get a different look. As always, if you like this tutorial, leave a like. Any questions you have regarding this tutorial, please comment down below. Share it with more people so they can learn these techniques too. And please do consider subscribing to Motion Nerds for more tips and tutorials like this. And I'll be seeing you in the next one. Bye.